I'll show you how to change from this crappy focuser into this stylish one. And the best of all is that anybody can do it. It's inexpensive, it's precise, and it's strong. Besides, if you don't have any Virtuoso telescope, stay with me because this may give you new ideas for you to use in your telescope. But this upgrade is also harmless to your telescope, which means you can come back to the previous version if you want. I bet you don't. I always said from the beginning that the focuser of the Virtuoso telescope was its weakness. It's awkward, we had to upgrade it with Teflon tape to make it stiffer and less awkward, but even like that, it was not the best focuser. It was what we could do with this focuser to improve it. However, I still strongly recommend this telescope for beginners, because it has it all. It's inexpensive, it does imaging, it does visual, and you can take it anywhere for a good price, as you can see in my sponsor AstroArt Finland, your astronomical partner. But all this time I was searching for a better solution. However, so far I didn't find anyone that could give me what I wanted. And one of my strong requirements was an upgrade that would be harmless, which means no heavy work, no drilling, no cutting the focuser, nothing like that. You could think in a helicoidal focuser just inserted in this one to solve the problem. But there's a problem with that. If you insert a focuser like that into this focuser, it will push the imaging or visual train upwards. Which means, if you want to use a focal reducer, for instance, that needs more inner focus, you will have to move the sliders down too much. So much that will cut the light cone, and we don't want that. But during one of our live streams, one of our channel members, Fred Led, showed us on camera a nice solution. It looks good, but he had a problem, and I gave him my opinion. The fact that it's sustained by the contact with the new focuser and the old one by tape, it's not very reliable to me, because we all know what happens with the tape with temperature variations and with time. It bends, it deforms, and it might introduce tilt into the focuser. But I'm glad he did it, because it triggered in my brain a new idea. Basically, I use this 2-inch extension with a characteristic. It doesn't have the down barrel, so it's like cutted, and with M42 thread inside. I will leave you all the links for this project, which requires only 3 pieces and inexpensive ones, at dobsonianpower.com. Virtuoso section, of course. So this is the first part that you need. This extension. This one has 40 mm, which is a low profile and fits perfectly in this focuser. Of course, you will get rid of the draw tube of the focuser, the old one, and you will attach this extension upside down into the focuser. After you attach it and tight well, it will stay strong as a castle. Then you will need this very low profile helicoidal focuser. And this is another trick. The one that Fred Led used was larger. This one is very low profile, which means with this and the extension, you still have room for more, because you will not pass the old measures of the previous focuser, the crappy one. And the third part you need, it's this adapter. It's a simple ring, M42 to M48 male. This will complete the setup and will allow you to fit any 2-inch camera imaging train with any M48 thread, like filters, reducers, the camera itself, anything. However, if you are going to follow my suggestion, I strongly recommend you to buy also, if you don't have already at home, a simple 2-inch to 1¼-inch adapter. This is used to the 2-inch focusers when you want to use a 1¼ eyepiece or Barlow. This will allow you to keep doing the regular visual sessions with a Virtuoso, just having to screw this into the new focuser. And it has another advantage, which is if you need to collimate with a cap that comes with a Virtuoso, you just have to insert it here and collimate. By the way, very important, and this is the only weak part of this project, but the good news is that you only have to do it once, and then it will keep well forever. I'm talking of controlling the tilt. If the old focuser was a bit jerky, this one it isn't, but it needs to be precise from the beginning. I mean, first you should collimate a telescope, like always, with this crappy focuser that you can still use if you want. You screw it, you place the collimation cap, and you collimate, as usual, the telescope. Then, after collimated, you take this off and insert the new extension. And that's the moment that you have to be careful. When inserting the extension, you want to eliminate any tilt. So what I recommend you to do is to insert again this adapter, the new one, 1¼ to 2-inch, with a collimation cap inside, and then try to place everything as closer as possible to the perfect collimation, with a small dot dead centered. It's almost mission impossible, but it doesn't matter. It will be slightly off, but you adjusting the extension when tightening very well with the two screws, you can adjust and the other end in a way that it will be more or less centered. Make sure you tighten everything very well, because it will be like that forever. Then you readjust the collimation, just fine-tuning to the small dot be where it should be, at the center. And from now on, you will collimate always this telescope without taking that extension out again. In the links I found, for Europe you have every parts exactly like mine. But for United States, I could only find so far the extension with 50 mm, which mean you will add 10 more millimeters comparing to mine. That's not too much relevant, but just for you to know. Besides, remember that the links to the helicoidal focuser will lead you to have different measures. Mine is 17 mm to 31 mm. It's the middle range, which means I only add to the imaging train 17 mm. But as I took off the old draw tube, it compensates, no problem at all. However, if you want less thickness, you can buy it. Just remember that it will not move so much. And if you need more distance with a helicoidal focuser, you can buy a larger thickness. However, remember, the more you have, the more distance you will add to the focal plane. Mine, I think it's a fair measure. It's the equivalent of the movement up and down that the old draw focuser had, so fair enough. Also, I strongly recommend you, when buying the M42 to M48 adapter, to buy the one with the characteristics mine has, because the one I have will allow you to take off much easier anything from the imaging train. Mine has like some teeth around it, so it grips to your hand much easier and stronger. Now click on this video over here if you want to know more about this wonderful and inexpensive telescope.